Hello everyone and welcome back to the Python Image Library Module Tutorial Video Series. That's a tongue twister, and today we're going to be jumping into the putPixel function. Now, the putPixel function is handy, but also slow. So, that's kind of why I wanted to introduce you guys and talk to you about it, and I'm surprised I haven't showed it to you earlier, because I actually use this quite a bit in a lot of the Python Challenge videos. So, PutPixel will do pretty much exactly what it says. It puts a pixel onto the image. It takes a position argument, which is typically a tuple of an x and y coordinate, and it takes a color, which is often at least a tuple for multi-band images like RGB or RGBA for red, green, and blue, and then the alpha value. So if you've got a single-band image that only takes one value, like black or white, that sort of thing, you would only pass in one integer. But in our case, we're going to be working mostly with multi-band images like red, green, and blue, and red, green, blue, and alpha. So that's why we will do that. Now, I do want to caution you with this putPixel function because it is very, very slow. The documentation, stuff that I've been checking out online, which I totally recommend you do some research and some reading on your own, but it specifies that version 1.1.6 of this image, Python image library and the module, the load function will actually get into pixel access objects, and I'll show you that in a coming tutorial, but pixel access objects are much, much faster at actually using getPixel and putPixel, which are the two functions, at least putPixel I'm showing you now, but getPixel I showed you earlier. So putPixel, of course, works kind of like the reverse of getPixel. GetPixel is going to retrieve pixel and color like information from the image, and putPixel is going to put pixel and color information on the image. So if you're going to do this a lot, if you're going to put a lot of pixels on the screen, it's actually a lot better to use putData, which of course I've showed you getData earlier, and I've said getPixel is kind of the opposite of putPixel, and putPixel the opposite of getPixel. putData is pretty much the same thing for getData. Takes a Python list, and then you use putData to slap it on the image. And of course, for more extensive changes, you can probably use the paste function, which I've shown you earlier, and even on top of that, you should be using ImageDraw, which is another module that hopefully I'll get into very, very soon in later videos. But that's what you should be using rather than putPixel. But of course, for educational purposes and for me wanting to show you, because it's, I don't know, the internet, I want to show people stuff, we're going to go through putPixel. So what I'm going to do is actually loop through my image for x in range of width. And I know that my image is a square because I've been working with this the entire series. We could just as easily say for y in range of height. The range is the only one that matters here, but I know it's like a value 200, whether or not it be width or height. So I'm just going to use x. And I'm going to use the same thing for x and y coordinates, so that way it's essentially drawing a line. And of course it's going to need our color, 0, 0, 0, and I'm going to use 255 for my alpha value. Now if I run this, you can check it out. What it's done is it has successfully essentially drawn this line, because it's called the putPixel function over and over and over again with our loop. So this is slow, but it gets the job done, and I've actually used it a lot in the Python Challenge videos along with getPixel, but in a real programming scenario where I actually care about time and efficiency and speed, it's much more recommended to use pixel access objects, which I'll get into very, very soon. But thank you guys for watching. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.